Hello friends, in this video we will brief you about fast Ethernet and gigabit Ethernet. Why to study Ethernet? In this era of increasing technology, we need to know about how network communication occurs over various ranges. In this, we are going to cover topics that are fast Ethernet and gigabit Ethernet, in which we will study about MAC sublayer, physical layer, implementation strategies, topologies used in both fast Ethernet and gigabit Ethernet. Now, what is Ethernet? Ethernet is a family of computer networking technologies commonly used in local area networks, that is LAN, metropolitan area networks, that is MAN, and wide area networks, that is WAN. It was commercially introduced in 1980 and first standardized in 1983 as IEEE standard, that is 802.3, and has since been refined to support higher bit rates and longer link distances. Now, we'll see about what is fast Ethernet. Fast Ethernet was designed to compete with LAN protocols such as FDDI or fiber channel. IEEE created Fast Ethernet under the name 802.3U. Fast Ethernet is backward compatible with standard Ethernet, but it can transmit data 10 times faster at a rate of 100 Mbps. The goals of Fast Ethernet can be summarized as follows. Upgrade the data rate to 100 Mbps. Second, make it compatible with standard Ethernet. Third, keep the same frame format, and fifth, to keep the same minimum and maximum frame lengths. Now the nomenclature of fast Ethernet. For example, 100 base X. 100 stands for transmission speed of 100 megabits per second. Base defines the baseband signaling. T and F defines the physical medium that carries the signal. X and 4, etc. defines the line code method used. Next, we'll see the evolution of fast Ethernet, that is MAC sublayer and physical layer. MAC sublayer, a main consideration in the evolution of Ethernet from 10 to 100 megabits was to keep the MAC sublayer untouched. However, a decision was made to drop the bus topologies and keep only the star topologies. For the star topology, there are two choices as we saw before. First is half duplex and second is full duplex. In the half duplex approach, these stations are connected via a hub. In the full duplex approach, the connection is made via a switch with the buffers at each port. Second feature is auto negotiation. A new feature added to fast Ethernet is called auto negotiation. It allows a station or a hub a range of capabilities. Auto negotiation allows two devices to negotiate the mode or data rate of operation. It connects the incompatible devices to one another. It allows one device to have multiple capabilities. And third, it allows a station to check a hub's capabilities. Of fast Ethernet. The physical layer in fast Ethernet is more complicated than the one in standard Ethernet. We briefly describe some features of this layer. The topologies used in fast Ethernet are point-to-point topologies and star topologies. Now, the encoding schemes of fast Ethernet are as follows. First is 100 base TX. 100 base TX is the predominant form of fast Ethernet and runs over two wire pair inside a category of 5 or above cable. Like 10 base T, the active pairs in a standard connection are terminated on pin 1, 2, 3 and 6. Second is 100 base FX. Uses the two pair of fiber optic cable. Uses NRZ1 encoding scheme for its implementation. Third is 100 base T4, which was an early implementation of fast Ethernet. It requires four twisted copper pairs, but those pairs were only required to be category 3 rather than the category of 5 required by the TX. One pair is reserved for transit, one for receive, and the remaining two will switch direction as negotiated. Now we'll learn about what is gigabit Ethernet. The need for an even higher data resulted in the design of gigabit Ethernet protocol. The IEEE committee calls the standard 802 gigabit Ethernet design can be summarized as follows. It upgrades the data rate to 1 Gbps. It makes it compatible with standard or fast Ethernet. It uses the same 48 bit address as it was used in fast Ethernet. It uses the same frame format. It keeps the same minimum and maximum frame lengths. It supports the auto negotiation as defined in Fast Ethernet. Now we'll learn about the evolution of Gigabit Ethernet, that is MAC sublayer and physical sublayer, as it was described in Fast Ethernet. Now the MAC sublayer. The main consideration in the evolution of Ethernet was to keep the MAC sublayer untouched. However, to achieve a data rate of 1 Gbps, there was no longer possible. Gigabit Ethernet has two distinctive approaches for medium access. That is, first is half duplex and another is full duplex. Almost all implementation of Gigabit Ethernet follow the full duplex approach. In full duplex mode of Gigabit Ethernet, there is no collision. In half duplex mode of Gigabit Ethernet, there is collision, but it is rarely used. Now, we'll speak about the physical layer. The physical layer in Gigabit Ethernet is more complicated than in standard or fast Ethernet. We briefly described about the features of this layer. First is topologies. The topologies used in Gigabit Ethernet is point-to-point, two-star topology, and hierarchy of star topologies. Let's have a look on the diagram of different topologies. First is point-to-point topologies, in which two PCs are connected in point-to-point connection. Figure B shows different. Figure B shows three devices which are connected via a switch, which defines it as a star topology. Figure C shows the two-star topology, which defines three individual PCs which are connected via a switch. Fourth is a switch which is connected to the individual switches of the two star topologies. Now, the various types of Gigabit Ethernet. The first type of Gigabit Ethernet are 1000 base X. 1000 base X is used in industry to refer Gigabit Ethernet transmission over fiber, where options include 1000 base SX, 1000 base LX, 1000 base LX10, 1000 base BX10 or the non-standard EX and ZX implementations. Included are copper variants using the same 8 bits by 10 bits line code. First is 1000 base LX. It was standardized 6 years after the initial gigabit fiber version as a part of the internet Ethernet in the first mile task group. It is practically identical to 1000 base LX but achieves longer distances up to 10 kilometers over a pair of single mode fiber due to the higher quality optics. Second is 1000 base CX. 1000 base CX is an initial standard of Gigabit Ethernet connections with the maximum distance of 25 meters used balance shielded twisted pair and either DE9 or 8P8C connector. The second type is 1000 base SX. The 1000 base SX is an optical fiber Gigabit Ethernet standard for operation over multimode fiber using a 770 to 860 nanometer near infrared light wavelength. This standard is highly popular for intra building links in large offices building, local locations, co-locations, facilities and carrier neutral internet exchanges. The last is 1000 base T. It is standard Gigabit Ethernet over copper wiring. 1000 base T network segment can be maximum length of 100 meters and must use category 5 cable. In order to extend and maximize the use of existing CAT5E and CAT6 cabling, additional next generation and standard 2.5 base T and 5 base T will operate at 2.5 and 5.0 gigabit per second, respectively, on existing copper infrastructure designed for use with 1000 base T. It is based on the 10G base T but uses low power signal frequencies. Now, these are the two diagrams of encoding. First diagram includes 1000 base SX, 1000 base LX and 1000 base CX, which describes the two fiber or two STPs, and next diagram shows the 1000 base T, which describes the four UTB cables. Thank you.